Finally tonight, in case you had any doubts, America is still the land of opportunity. The young man you're about to meet is living proof. Seth Doan has his story.
He's so quick, so quiet, that one could easily overlook Jose Gutierrez. But his story is as inspiring as the exhibits he polishes at this museum. As a kid in Mexico, he'd seen pictures of the Statue of Liberty and dreamed of a better life in the U.S. So at just 15, Jose crossed the border without his parents, a journey made more difficult considering he's deaf. Friends told me I'd be able to work in the U.S., he says, but when I got here, everything fell apart. By age 17, Jose was living like a slave, forced to sell trinkets on the subways and streets of New York City, and turn over the money he made to the bosses of a smuggling ring in exchange for shelter. Then in July of 1997, New York City police raided the smuggling ring.
They were essentially being used as slaves, which is unthinkable in the modern world.
Jose was allowed to stay in the U.S. and learned of a nonprofit group which helps people with disabilities find work.
I can tell you he set out to work every day, support his family, and he did what he needed to do to get the job.
And he found a job at that museum, Ellis Island, the entry point for 12 million immigrants. I clean the exhibits, Jose tells me, and I think about all the different places that they came from and all the things they went through, just like I did coming to America. And now he works in the shadow of the Statue of Liberty. I saw it and I had goosebumps, he says. I couldn't stop looking at it. I just kept taking pictures. I was crazy. I took way too many photos. Now he has a daughter and a green card. It was a dream to be able to come here and to get a job and to succeed. And I love it, and I love America, and I love working. Dusting off the displays of his own American dream. Seth Doan, CBS News, Ellis Island.